right, so I'm just going to get into it. I think it's more than fair to say that Lele Pons is absolute pond scum. And I'm really not trying to sound like a jerk when I say that. It's just I think that Lele Pons sucking is probably the most agreeable stance on the internet right now. And that is if the tremendous amount of exposed videos are anything to go by. I don't think people like her, but for good reason, honestly. She's managed to accumulate nearly 25 million followers off of being an unfunny, self-obsessed, manipulative skank.
That sounds kind of harsh, but I mean, it's Lele Pons, keep in mind, and I don't think she's gonna lose any sleep over this video whatsoever. If you've never heard of Lele Pons, you probably just got out of a coma? I'll put it this way. Remember that one terrible internet sketch you saw a couple weeks ago that made you want to gouge your eyes out and scream until you develop permanent vocal cord damage? Yeah, she was a blonde Latina. If you use the internet, there is no way you haven't seen her. Everyone below the age of 30 knows who she is at this point. She's been seen on Instagram, Vine, YouTube, Snapchat, Twitter, Musical.ly, YouTube Rewind, the Grammys, and Target commercial? No. She's everywhere. Lele originated on Vine, partaking in brilliant productions such as...
Don't drink.
Fuck that.
And was then thrusted into the spotlight as the app began to take off. Of course, once Vine eventually Cobained itself, she was forced to find other means of exposure. Unsurprisingly, her YouTube channel quickly skyrocketed to an A on Social Blade, garnering over 8 million subscribers and a total of 1.3 billion views. The $3,600 she makes a day then translates to an estimate of nearly $2.3 million a year through AdSense revenue alone. So yeah, our girl's doing just fine for herself, don't you worry. Which is great, you know, I'm happy for her success. Or at least I would be if her content wasn't ungodly awful. I know I sound like I have a vendetta out for this chick, but like, have you seen her stuff?
Okay, boys night. Love you.
Did you put it on?
No, did you put it on yours?
I did. Did you?
I put it on mine. Check it out.
Log in.
Do we have a sight on the Eagles?
So right off the bat, we already have these two psychopaths putting cameras on their boyfriend's jackets to make sure they aren't cheating or perhaps gay, because that's totally a sane person does in a relationship, right? Right?
But you know what? I love Lily.
Aww.
No, I love him too, though. Well, like, we love him.
I love them.
Yeah, that's why I love them.
They have great personalities and, you know...
That's true.
Yeah, that's true.
After Lele flatters herself with how great her personality is, we then see them show up to some thoughts house where these thoughts are pissed that their thoughts are flirting with other thoughts. As you can imagine, hilarity ensues.
They're cheating on us.
Oh my god, it's so big. Watch. Nice.
Must be expensive.
God. You're exactly what we wanted. Let's help save the children.
Okay.
Yo! The big boss wants to see you.
They're part of a gang. They're part of a gang.
For your girls. The rings you wanted.
Yes. Wait a minute. What? Huh?
They love it, bro.
Is that pretty? Wedding rings?
Are we getting, what? We're getting married!
That is until it's revealed that the boyfriends somehow know about the cameras and take them off. Then the video just ends on this?
They thought we didn't notice the cameras.
Well, now that that's cleared up, let's get to the real deal.
What? Kind of a confusing note, to be honest. Were the guys actually gay, like they suspected? Or were they a part of a gang? And if so, were they really cheating? Because wouldn't that affect their proposals? Or were they aware of the cameras the entire time and were trying to fool the girls with the wedding rings to throw them off? Because if that's the case, why did they flirt with random girls in front of their girlfriends to begin with? Am I putting too much thought into this?
Yes!
But I'm trying to make the point clear that Lele doesn't even think through her own atrocious comedy acts. Like, this garbage doesn't even make sense. I know she's a Viner, but she can't even coherently write a 4-minute sketch. Do you know how infuriating that is? It's not just her YouTube videos, though. Her Instagram trash is almost terribler. Girls be like, Latinas be like, Latina girls be like. Enough with the glow-up pics every 5 posts! What do you even want me to say about this? Pandering, stupid, disgusting, absolutely haram! I don't know. Look at this, okay? This is uploaded to an account with over 20 million
followers.
Oh, wait, look at the word. Wait, Hannah just taught us the eye thing. Wait, what are
show you? Show us.
Perpendicular, remember?
Oh!
Yeah, you did it.
If you're starting to notice a trend, that would be the relentless screaming involved. Her skits always have to contain some sort of yelling or screaming or crying or a painfully obnoxious song ripped from a top 40s list. Because in Lele's mind, loud equals funny.
Are you ready for Coachella?
Also, be sure to joke about your ethnicity in some way, because apparently that's the trend as well. She cheated, and she's Latina. Funny, funny. Not only is this method incredibly derivative and unfunny, but my big problem is that portraying yourself in such a way does little more than give in to these ridiculous stereotypes. You'd think that as a Latina comedian, Lele would feel more inclined to break the formula and showcase a more realistic or diverse side of her nationality. But instead, she chooses to exhibit the stereotypes themselves, holding your hand, walking you through the jokes without challenging the status quo at all, making for an overall predictable and incredibly bland experience. Which is fine if that's the hill you want to die on, but it sure loses a lot of comedic value once you've done it 50,000 times. Although if you think her ulcer-inducing demeanor stops there, buckle up, kids. So, putting aside her cataclysmic lineup of content, Lele is also shockingly adept at being a manipulative leech. Example number one. I am confident you've heard of the hair incident. Basically, early last year, she made a post on Instagram saying, "Donating my hair! First time I ever cut my hair! What do you think?" Cool, great. She announces that she's giving part of her hair to charity. I don't care. That is until a kind saint on Twitter pointed out how the hair she had in her hands wasn't really hair at all. They were extensions. She then took to Twitter, where she explained how she wanted to donate her hair without realizing she couldn't because her hair is treated or something. She still posted the picture. I mean, she's tricking her audience of 9-year-olds that she's a better person than she really is, which is really, really sad. When you have to stoop to such miserable lows in an attempt to boost your public image, you've officially hit rock bottom. I don't even think I need to reiterate that. It's dumb, and it really just makes you look entirely shallow and desperate in every single way possible. But I mean, hey, when you're Lele Pons, you have no reason to care less, because all it means is more publicity for you, so in that regard, I guess we all lose. Now let's you and me take a little dive into how abysmally vain Lele happens to be. See, about 8 months ago, a Viner by the name of Jesse Smiles made a video where she described how various Viners have treated her in past years, specifically, you guessed it, Lele Pons. And as jolting as this may sound, Lele is not that great of a human being.
My experiences with Lele Pons have always sucked. I'm pretty sure that the reason why she just did not like me was two things. Number one, because she was threatened by me, and I'm not saying that in a cocky way whatsoever, because who the fuck am I? But she is so insecure about numbers, about everything, that when I had more followers than her on Vine, she did not know how to compute that in her brain.
Jesse goes on to explain how compulsively threatened Lele was by her gain in followers, and describes her as being completely insecure when it came to numbers in general, which likely led to this little interaction.
So I went up to Lele. I'll never forget, it was her 18th birthday. I went up to her and I was like, "Oh, happy birthday. Do you want to come to Cheesecake Factory with us?" And I shit you not, this bitch, she looks at me and she's like, "Well, you're the famous one, so you decide." What does that even mean?
And she basically talks about how blatantly rude Lele was, not only to Jesse, but also to her brother for some reason.
Went to Cheesecake Factory, she ended up coming, and my brother Joey went up to her because he hadn't met her yet. He goes up to her face to face, like, you know, like how humans meet. And he said something along the lines of like, "Oh, I don't think we've met yet. I'm Joey." No shit. She looks at him with a blank stare and then just stares off and walks away. He didn't take offense to this, but it was really awkward and weird.
And then naturally, when Lele passed Jesse and Vine followers, this allegedly took place.
And then Miss Lele comes in, I don't know who she thinks she is, goes to a nail salon in Brickell that my friend works at. And that was around the time where she had just passed me in followers. followers, which I didn't even realize because I stopped checking Vine like 4 years ago. Point is, she goes to this nail salon, and while she was there, I'm pretty sure she was with a friend or something, and she was bragging in a nail salon, a public setting, about how she had just passed me in followers. That same day, my friend, who is a nail technician at that nail salon, texted me and was like, this bitch is here talking shit, and I was like, well, she sucks, so I'm not surprised.
I know you're probably sitting there in disbelief of how this woman could ever come across as an unlikable skag, but trust me, her tendency to regard her friends as no more than mere competition only worsens. The reason I even brought up the Jesse Smiles thing was to properly segue into this little fiasco. If you know who Lele Pons is, there is no chance you haven't heard of Amanda Cerny. The two of them used to be pretty close friends, actually. Helping each other out with their own pandering, wince-worthy sludge, it's nice. At least until the war.
I'm dealing with this girl who was supposed to be my best friend, and turns out she wasn't, and she was trying to ruin my career, but yeah. I guess that's how things go in LA.
On her vlogging channel, Amanda alludes to how her once perceived best friend tried sabotaging her entire career and how reluctant she felt to make it public. Until Lele, of course, started spreading loads and loads of misinformation. You know, as you do.
I found out like a month and a half ago that she was deleting all of my successful videos on Instagram and on YouTube, and putting my account on private and tagging me in photos. And then she said she didn't want to talk about it, and then she said, because she's Latina.
Deleting your best friend's post behind their back, then blaming it on your ethnicity. Profound. It's like if I went to go dox you and then blamed it on the fact that I'm white. It genuinely makes no sense. Apart from spying on their boyfriends, apparently, do Latinas just steal their friends' personal belongings and delete whatever it is they want without the slightest bit of consent? Like, is that a thing that happens? I've known a lot of Latinas in my life, and I've never had that occur. And I know this drama is a bit stale by now, but I'm in awe still at the fact that she thinks that's a legitimate excuse. Glorious, Lele, well done. She explains how Lele went crazy, sicking her fan pages on Amanda, even sending two cops up to her apartment to personally ask she delete the text she posted. Like, what? There's no reason she should have to take the screenshots down. Lele's followers have every right to know what a snake she is. You can't manipulate the public in such a way. Or, I mean, you shouldn't. Honestly, good on Amanda for not backing down and showing Lele that she can't get off easy every single time. The truth always prevails, right? All this does is reinforce the fact that she's far too self-absorbed to do the right thing. She's so blinded by numbers and money that she physically cannot handle the thought of anyone being, God forbid, more successful than her. Rooting your self-worth in your fame is not a wise path to go down, and if Lele hasn't learned that by now, she's gonna have a rough time once she officially joins the Dead Channels Association in 7 years. Now, despite all of the shady and unfunny factors circulating in a whirlwind around Lele Pons' pathetic excuse of an existence, you may be wondering how she's so incredibly imminent. The shallow and vitriolic shell of a physique Lele inhabits is conventionally attractive. She's hot, or at least she is to some people, I guess. Which is kind of the trend with most of these Instagram comedians. I mean, that's really all it comes down to. Shove her insipid personality into this man, and all of a sudden, you've literally taken away everything that makes Lele Pons, Lele Pons. She has made a name of herself by being a model. Nothing more and nothing less. And when society elevates and extols her tasteless entertainment, then we begin to glorify mediocrity, abandoning all that user-generated content originally stood for. A blatant reminder that YouTube's best quality is also its worst quality, in the sense that everyone with access to it has the ability to upload whatever they want. And praising Lele's god-awful schlock does nothing but generate a tolerance for substandard videos. Of course, they look nice. They may all flaunt impressive production value, but once you go deeper, they merely serve as a way for companies like Shot Studios to cash in on impressionable and emotionally vulnerable tweens who couldn't care less about how uninspired their role models are. Most of Lele's target audience just wants some sort of role model to look up to, someone that they can relate to. The flat jokes that continuously spew out of the mouths of well-known Instagram comedians are adequate at best and dreadfully uninspired at worst. Lele Pons hardly brings anything to the table in terms of comedic style. She isn't funny, but to a wide variety of middle schoolers, she's able to come across as relatable, trendy, and traditionally good-looking, which is really all that matters. And when you take that into consideration, I don't think there is anything more pathetic than upholding a dull, egotistical, manipulative, fake, monotonous comedian
primarily based off of looks alone. But at the same time, their popularity is inevitable, so I guess we're just gonna have to wait until all their channels fade out of the limelight and die, as we all do. Circle of life, everybody. In the meantime, though, if you have any other YouTubers or Instagram celebs you want me to talk about next, let me know in the comments down below, as I actually do make an effort to read them and take your suggestions to heart. Thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to check out my other videos that are about to pop up, and I hope you all have a fantastic day. Drive safe, God bless, and I'll see you next time. Beep on, beep on.